Good morning. Welcome, friends, to worship at Central United Methodist Church. Whether you are here with us in person, you are watching through the internet at whatever time you're watching, if you're watching on cable, there are so many ways to connect with us here. The order of worship this morning is in your bulletin, and if you are watching from afar, you can use the app, the Central UMC Endicott app, or the website has that order of worship for you. For those of you who are here in the pews, we are at a low COVID threat, I guess, and so masks are optional. We are grateful for those that wear them. We are grateful for those who choose not to. So please know that that is at your comfort at this point. And we still ask that you take care of the distancing and using the hand sanitizer and things like that. But masks themselves, even when we are singing, are optional. If you can take a moment and fill out the friendship pad at the end of the pew, that would be great. We do use that for contact tracing even now. It is like a purple or an orange pad, It's a purple or a maroon pad at the end of the pew. You put your name and address in it and pass it down. If you do have any symptoms or you have COVID, you get a positive test over the week, please call the church office so that we can let the folks who are sitting around you know. And so I am super excited to be here with Maggie, and we are here to worship together.
Introduce yourself.
Oh, and I am Pastor Laurel, and it is great to be with you.
Good morning, everyone. As Pastor Laurel said, I'm Maggie Wolford. I'm going to be your co-host and liturgist this morning. There is a lot going on. I don't know. I think that Jeff might have cheated. He joked about the Sunday that he preached being one of the hottest Sundays of the summer. And we are going to be getting his sermon today via video, so he doesn't physically have to be in the sanctuary. But it is quite warm, and if that heat gets to be too much for anyone, we do have the church office open and the air conditioner going. If you just need to take a break or get some fresh air, that is completely fine. It is through the double doors here and just down the hall. Let's see. So as I mentioned, Jeff is going to be doing the scripture today. Sean and I are going to be doing some of the music. We've got an amazing tech team back there making everything happen. We've got Carol and Nate. I know that Tyler helped out, but is also ushering, so he's sort of doing double duty today. Mark, I think, and I feel like there's someone else back there. Jason. Thank you, everyone.
And Scott.
Yes, I forgot. We have a new person in the tech booth today. Thank you so much, Scott. Okay. We've got people that are keeping an eye on the chat and the live stream. If you are watching on YouTube, do just remember that you need to be checked in or signed in to your official account to leave comments. Those of you who are in the sanctuary, feel free to join the conversation there as well. You'll likely see Pastor Laurel and I on our phones a few times. Don't worry, we're not zoning out. We're just greeting people and getting a little jealous when people talk about the weather where they are. So as we come in to worship this morning, we do have a prayer to begin our time together, whether it is physically here in the sanctuary or for someone viewing at home, please join in the words on the screen. Patient Lord, we schedule our lives down to the very second. We crowd in as much activity as we can and then wonder why we are so stressed out and tired. We are afraid to miss out on anything. And when it comes time to be with others, we spend our time worrying about details rather than longing for the visit. Forgive us when we get so caught up in the details and miss the opportunity to sit at your feet, learning, listening, and growing in our faith. Help us to place ourselves in your care. Slow us down just a bit, so that we can see the wonders you have placed before us and truly enjoy and share the blessings you have given to us. Amen. Our first hymn this morning is going to be number 2128 in the Black Hymnal, Come and Find the Quiet Center. It might not be the most familiar name, but I promise you know the tune. Please stand as you are willing or able to join in song.
Be seated. Oh, I guess not. Wow, this is a great day, friends. So, first of all, love that song. Thank you, Jeff, for choosing it. I love when new lyrics are put to old music, so you don't have to worry so much about knowing the tune, but you get to really lean into the words. I thought it's true. And so, we're going to pass the peace of Christ with one another, and over the past year or so, we have been doing that in a COVID-friendly way by using American Sign Language. And so if you would like to do it this way, you're welcome to throw the peace sign around as well. But you right hand over left and turn your hands over. Arms down. That's peace I give to you. And so right hand over left. Peace I give to you. Pass the peace with one another. You'll get the hang of it, no worries. And for Barb and Libby and Marianne and the Scots, and there's probably other people that whose names I already forgot that are on the live stream. Peace. Oh, and Larry, I give to you. This morning, I wanted to talk about one of the shortest prayers that you can pray. I think there are a list of five of them that you can pray using just one word. But today's word, summary set, is help. This weekend for me was, it's kind of like looking down, looking at the top of the mountain and saying, I have no idea how I'm going to get there. It was Wednesday or so, and I realized that we had movie night, which was amazing, by the way. We had movie night, and then there was a funeral, and then we had worship this morning, which I was scheduled to preach for the first time this summer. And I talked to the soul care group, and I was like, help. And so Jeff stepped forward and said, you know, I am preaching at my church. I can just take a video of what I'm preaching, and I can give you the order of worship, and I can share that with you. And I was like, oh, thank you, Jesus. And then I called Maggie. And I was like, but then I'm going to be sitting up front by myself. Help! And she was like, yeah, that's fine. Even though we're going to laugh and joke the whole time. Great. And then it came time for movie night, and we were worried that we weren't going to have enough volunteers. So, help! And Suzette and Mark and Art and Donna and my mom, we had this wonderful time, and things got cleaned up like 2 hours sooner than they did the first time. We're definitely shortening that learning curve. And so this whole weekend, and the last one was when I gave away the flowers for the altar at the funeral on Saturday. And Andy had tried to hide them so that I didn't do that, and I did it anyway. I was like, oh, there's extra flowers. And so thank you to the Altar Guild and for Carla for making flowers reappear, and for Andy for taking care of all that, and for Sean and coming and doing the funeral, and Mark for teaching me how to use the microphones by myself. It's just been that one word, help, is probably one of the most powerful prayers and powerful requests that you can send to God. And I am grateful for this church family. I am grateful to God for all the help that has come. And so if you ever feel like you need to pray a prayer and keep it simple, just help. Amen.
Harder than a lie. The dark seems safer than the light. And everyone has a heart that loves to hide. I'm a mess and so are you. We build walls nobody can get through. Maybe but the best thing we could ever do, ever do. Bring your brokenness and I'll bring mine. 'Cause love can heal what hurt divides. Mercy's waiting on the other side. If we're pretend to be something that you're not, living life afraid of getting caught. Yeah, there's freedom found when we lay our secrets down at the cross, at the cross. So bring your brokenness and I'll bring mine, 'cause love can heal what hurt divides. If we're honest,
scripture reading this morning.
Our scripture reading this morning also comes from Jeff via video, and I do think they're two separate videos, so there might be a little bit of lag between the two. Oh, good. Just kidding. They're only one video. And so thank you for riding on the roller coaster with me this morning, friends. And so Jeff will be reading scripture and doing the sermon via video this morning.
Hi, everyone. It's good to be with you today. I'm also looking forward to worshiping with many of you in the sanctuary next Sunday. We'll be talking about the Lord's Prayer. Let's hope it cools down a little by then. Our scripture for today comes from Luke chapter 10, verses 38 through 42. And this comes right after Jesus has shared the parable of the Good Samaritan, which Maggie talked about last week. Hear these words from Luke. Now, as they went on their way, Jesus entered a certain village where a woman named Martha welcomed him. She had a sister named Mary, who sat at Jesus' feet and listened to what he was saying. But Martha was distracted by her many tasks, so she came to him and asked, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to do all of the work by myself? Tell her then to help me." But the Lord answered her, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and distracted by many things, but few things are needed. Indeed, only one. Mary has chosen the better part, which will not be taken away from her." It's hard to imagine this passage is some 2,000 years old. It's so relatable. Haven't we all at one time or another felt like Martha, wondering how everything that needed to be done fell into our laps while others were seemingly just passing the time? I know I have, especially when I think back to my work career. And let's be honest, haven't we also been like Mary once in a while, momentarily ignoring the fact that there's probably something we could be doing to help out? Yeah, I've been there too. When I first read this passage, I really sympathized with Martha. We don't really know what task she is busying herself with because Luke doesn't say. I imagine she's likely prepping the food and setting the table for her important guests. And she's probably a bit tense about it. I mean, they're hosting Jesus and his disciples. I'm sure she wants things to go well. And she's feeling all the burden of that falling on her shoulders alone. Why isn't Mary helping her? And when she asks Jesus to do something about it, he rebukes her pretty harshly. That's pretty interesting, actually, because this gathering is happening right after Jesus shared the parable of the Good Samaritan, a lesson in showing mercy and being hospitable. Isn't that exactly what Martha was trying to do? Jesus is pretty stern with her. Maybe what Jesus is telling Martha is there is more to hospitality than food and drink. Mary is the one showing true hospitality by respecting her guest and giving him her full attention. Martha was probably getting a bit exasperated and frustrated at this situation, distracted by trying to do everything herself, and it got the best of her. What a good time that would have been to take a breath for a moment. Maybe Martha could have then said, "Excuse me, but Mary, could I speak to you in the kitchen for a moment?" And then more quietly said, "Do you think you could give me a hand here?" Asking Jesus to intervene wasn't the most hospitable thing to do. And it was a little rude to Mary as well. So that's one way to read this story. That's one set of insight to walk away with. But remember, this story is 2,000 years old. There's another lesson here involving things that aren't being said. Now, I usually get myself in trouble when I try to comment on issues of gender. As a privileged white male, I don't have much credibility on the subject. I'd like to say the story would be just as poignant if Jesus had come along the house of two brothers. But let's face it, if that had happened, they probably would have ordered out takeout and are watching TV. I really hope somebody laughed at that. I'm grateful that I came upon the writing of Karen Gonzalez when I was researching this passage. She reminded me how different our culture is today from that of the days of the New Testament. Jesus came into a world where women were less than second-class citizens. They were the property of men, first of their fathers, and then of their husbands. Because of this, they were never viewed as having anything to do with bearing the image of God. Luke says that Mary is sitting at the feet of Jesus. Now, some have interpreted that as Mary having a time of reflection with Jesus, a quiet time with him. But the phrase to sit at the feet of also means to be a student of. Mary is a follower of Jesus, and she is at his feet, learning from him, just as the male disciples are. They aren't having idle conversation. And this is a big deal. In those days, women were forbidden to even touch the Hebrew scriptures, let alone read or study them. Mary being there like this goes against all social and religious regulations of the time. Luke is revealing that Mary was Jesus' student and disciple, just like the other 12 men in the room who traveled with him. Jesus has invited Mary into a space that's currently forbidden for women. Here's another point. Luke describes that Martha was busy with many tasks. I said earlier, we could assume that those were probably related to preparing a meal. The Greek word for many tasks is diakonia. That's also the word from which we derive the term deacon. Maybe the many tasks Martha was involved with didn't involve kitchen work at all. Maybe it was work that the deacon of a worshiping community might have done. Ms. Gonzalez offers a whole other way for us to hear this story. The rabbi Jesus was received in the home of one of his apostles named Martha, who also fulfilled the duties of a deacon in the worshiping community in Bethany. On this day, her sister Mary sat at the feet of Jesus like his male disciples to study and learn from him. Martha asked the rabbi to have his student Mary help her with her own duties. But the rabbi responded that studying was just as important as serving and affirmed Mary's choice. Well, that's a different read, isn't it? Maybe Martha was tending to the many tasks of preparing a meal and setting a table for her guests. We will never know. But we do know this. Jesus praised Mary for being a student at his feet. Jesus affirmed that choice that Mary made. One of the many things that made Jesus a radical in his time was the way he elevated the view of women. He cared for them, talked with them, discipled them, and valued them as human beings. Jesus entrusted women with his ministry and mission. It's a big deal. This is such a short and sweet little passage, but it gives us so much to think about. Jesus reminds us to prioritize what we focus on. We cannot be at our best when we're trying to do 10 things at once. I'm reminded of this every time my wife says, "Jeff, you are only half listening to me." Guilty. We need to put our phones down. Look away from the screens. We need to listen to each other. Really listen. Jesus demonstrates his radical inclusion by having Mary join with the disciples in his teaching. All are welcome in the company of Jesus. And finally, the story is a reminder to focus on Jesus and what he has to say to us. No matter how busy we become, there is just one thing that matters. We need to leave room for the Spirit. As we sang earlier, we need to find the quiet center in the crowded life we lead. Clear the chaos and the clutter. Find the room for hope to enter. Clear our eyes that we can see all the things that really matter. Be at peace and simply be. And so I invite you to think about this story of Martha, Mary, and Jesus. Be affirming of all who follow Jesus. There's room for everyone on this journey. Be mindful of the distractions that threaten to invade your day and disrupt your ability to focus on what matters. And create a moment every day to find that quiet center where you can be at peace with Jesus and simply be. Amen.
Distraction can come in a number of forms. The laundry, the running after the kids, the bee that comes into the sanctuary in the middle of a really great message. Sometimes you have to deal with the thing first and put it away, and then you can pick back up what you need to be doing. And as we come into this time of prayer, I hope that you can put aside the distraction. Close your eyes if it helps. Just ground yourself where you are. There will be time to share prayer requests through the chat feature and here in the sanctuary to say where you have seen God at work in your world this week. The song will give you a little bit of time to think about that or to enter those into the chat. We're going to be doing Give Me Jesus, which is in the green hymnal, but I'm actually going to be doing a couple of verses that are not there. This is a spiritual, and so there's 100 different versions of this song, but I think that it's really beautiful, and especially given the message, it seems to tie in really well. So, as I said, close your eyes if you need to. Ground yourself as we prepare for prayer.
Give me Jesus.
I promise it's green. There we go. This allows us to pray for the entirety of our church family over the course of the year. If you recognize any of these names, I encourage you to reach out to them to see if they're well, to make sure that they're staying cool and taking care of themselves this summer. This week, we are particularly in prayer for James Bell, Sheila and Jeff Carpenter, Sharon DeMaria, David Garrison, Roger and Shirley Holmes, Joan Knapp, George Midwinter, Joan Rodolfi, Sandra Stranner, Carlton and Jane Williams. In the hospital or recovering at home this week, we continue to pray for Lillian City and Randy Foote, as well as Charles Witt. And family and friends with particular prayer needs this week, Jack and Jan Lair, Gladys Hansen, Margaret Frederick, and Richard Frederick. Coming in over the live stream, Barb asks for prayers for her oldest friend who lost her beloved aunt this week, and for an 18-year-old cat, a kitty, she says, who had a mild stroke last week and is fighting back like a little lion.
Maggie didn't mention it, but we also had like four or five, like, yeah, Maggie, you're amazing in the singing, and to let Jeff know that they were laughing as well. He even gets me laughing on the live stream. It's great. He's a wonderful preacher. I've been really grateful for this summer and being able to hear different voices. And there's still more to come in the next few weeks as well. And so are there any prayers that you would like to raise up? Any places where you have seen God this week?
Libby is giving thanks for so many who recently answered the prayer help.
Ah, Libby is giving thanks for those who answer the prayer help. Me too. There was a very good showing for the funeral yesterday for Robert Gillat, and that was beautiful. I definitely saw the face of God in the family and in the memory shared. Maggie. Maggie is giving thanks. It is Carrie's birthday, and you can just see the pride that radiates from her face and her heart. Any other prayers? Cindy. Yes. She asks for prayers as she takes her grandson to Philadelphia in the hottest week of the year to visit Legoland and the aquarium and all sorts of adventures to come, no doubt.
Yesterday was also Nate's birthday.
Yesterday was Nate's birthday also. Well, happy birthday, as the pride emanates from our faces as well for you. And so, friends, let us pray together. Provider God, helper God, thank you for walking alongside of us in our time of need. Thank you for carrying us. Thank you for surrounding us with a community of faith and love. We are grateful for birthdays. We are grateful for celebrations. And although we have heavy hearts, we are grateful for the celebration of life as it ends. We lift up all of these prayers. And in this moment of silence, we lift up these other names. God, you know every prayer that is on our heart before it even escapes our lips. For that, we are so grateful. We pray all of these things in the name of your Son, Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
As we come to a time of prayer over our gifts and offerings to God, I will remind everyone that there are so many ways to give. There is a basket. Is there still a basket back there?
There is still a basket.
There's a basket in the back for those who are in the sanctuary. There's also ways to give on the website, through the app. You can call the church office if you have any trouble setting that up. You can mail a check to the church office. You can do direct deposit through your bank, which is what we've started doing, and then you just don't even have to think about it. These gifts allow us to do so much in this community, continuing to offer Shepherd's Supper every Thursday, even when it's super hot, being able to bring people in and to offer great experiences like the movie night, and also being able to give people opportunities through the clothing center and so many other offerings of this church. I think that the fact that we're known as the church with the rainbow flags is in itself a ministry, and I'm really glad to be a part of this. So let us pray a prayer of blessing over this offering. Gracious God, you love us whomever we are, wherever we are. You know what's on our hearts. You know what has transpired in our lives to bring us to this time, in this moment. You know the gifts we give of our time, of our finances, of our many talents in music, in technology, in just being someone who's a smiling face to greet people as they come in. As we give these gifts back to you, to your glory, to your purpose, to carry on your ministries, we pray this prayer of blessing on them. May they grow, may they multiply, may our cups run over. Amen.
Amen. So this week, there is, I'm going to go through some announcements. If they are in the bulletin as well, you're always welcome to join via Zoom for our book study. Whether you have started to read or are considering starting to read the book that we are doing, it is Monday nights at 7:30. On Wednesdays at 10, we have a small group that meets called Soul Care, where we check in with each other. You're always welcome to join us there. This Wednesday at 6:30, we are going to be meeting at Chuckster's for mini golf. And Timmy has been asking to try mini golf every time we drive by Skate Estate. So no promises that that will go well, but you are welcome to join us. Mini golf is $10, and there's also ice cream afterwards at your own cost. But the church family is more than welcome to come and play and enjoy that as well.
And you are strongly encouraged to bring sunscreen and a hat and water, and to also just take care of yourself, because it's gonna be toasty.
And the next movie night, for those of you who are interested in either volunteering or coming, is going to be on Friday, August 19th. So you got lots of time to plan as well. But we're going to be watching the Minions movie, and so that should be really fun. And I think that that's it for the announcements that are in the bulletin. Please share the live stream if you are able on your social media feeds. And if you have email, we send out an email every week with announcements of like what we're doing and what's coming up and all the Zoom links. And so if you need that, you can either call the church office or find one of us after worship.
The Sacred Sites Open House.
Oh, and there is a Sacred Sites Open House coming up, I think, on the 24th?
I believe so, yes. On Sunday, July 24th.
And there's a whole list on the bulletin board outside, and you can look it up online as well. Everything from the mosque to this building to there's a lot of amazing historical sites around the county that you get to just go and pop in. It's like when your neighbor has an open house up the street and you always wanted to see inside their house. And so you go even though you don't want to buy it. You get to go and see these different sacred sites and just check them out with no pressure. So friends, it is such a gift to worship with you. We are going to sing our last song together. You may rise if you are able in body and spirit. It is number 395 in the red hymnal, and the words are also on the screen, called Take Time to Be Holy. Friends, may you find time and space away from the distraction to find the peace that only comes from Jesus. Go in peace, feel the peace, be the peace. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.